Today we will discuss about SQL Server Volume Key.
My name is Varun Kar and I welcome you on our YouTube channel Decode ITES. Decode ITES provides you single learning platform for multiple IT technologies.
Today's topics are what is foreign key, update and delete cascade in foreign key, and in demo we will see how to create foreign key, how to add foreign key in existing table, how to view properties of foreign key, and how to delete foreign key. What are characteristics of foreign key and what is foreign key? A foreign key, also known as referencing key, used to link two tables together. A link or relationship between two tables based on primary key of one table and foreign key of another table. A table has foreign key is called child table, whereas the table referred for primary or candidate key is called referenced or parent table. A foreign key column referred to primary key in another table prevents invalid insert in the foreign key column. The invalid insert is a value that is not a part of referred primary key column in another table. That means you can't insert any value which is not present in primary key referred column or parent column. When a value other than null is entered into foreign key column, the value must exist in referenced column. Otherwise, a foreign key violation error message is written. It discussed in previous characteristic, you can't enter anything which is not present in parent column of parent table. You will get foreign key violation message if you try to do so. The only value which is allowed other than the values of parent column is null. That means either you can enter null value or if you can enter the values present in primary key column of parent table. A foreign key can be linked to another table referencing column with unique constraints. This is helpful when parent table does not have any primary key or you want to refer a column other than primary key. So this is very useful when you try to do a foreign key relationship with other than primary key columns. You can have a unique key column in the table and you can refer that. The foreign key relationship is limited to single database. Closed database integrity cannot be implemented. If you want to do so, you need to use the triggers. Foreign key is not possible on temporary tables. The foreign key can be declared with the same tables on two columns. That means primary key and the foreign key will be a part of single table. In this case, your parent table and child table will be the single table only. This slide contains the pictorial example of foreign key and primary key relationship. You can see in student table, roll number is the primary key field which contains this much of values. And in child table, roll number is referring to primary key column of student table. So you can't enter anything which is not available in student table roll number. So when you try to enter anything which is not present in parent key or parent table, it's going to fail and you will get the foreign key violation message. Update and delete cascade in foreign key. SQL Server foreign key gives the option of delete and update cascade. This is very useful option and needs proper analysis before selecting this. For example, you want to delete or update the primary key column in parent table which is referred by some other child tables as a foreign key. When you try to do it, it will not allow to because those keys or those columns are bounded with foreign key constraint. If you try to do so, you will get the foreign key violation message. But what if you want to have it or what if you want to do it? Then you can use something update and delete cascade. Update and delete cascade are a very useful feature because it will replicate the same effects on all child tables referring to the parent table on that particular primary key. Delete cascade. Foreign key using this option, when you delete a key from a parent table, it deletes the record of referencing key from the child table. That means if you delete one of the primary key column record from parent table, all records referencing in child table will be automatically deleted. Similarly, in update cascade, when you update the key in parent table, it updates the records of referencing key for child table. That means if you update the primary key field value in parent table, it will update that value in corresponding child tables automatically. So these features are useful as well as risky. So please do a proper analysis or database designing while choosing these options. Let's move to SQL Server machine for demo of SQL Server foreign keys.
Welcome to demo session of SQL Server foreign key. In this session, we will go through with the different actions over foreign keys. We have a demo script ready for this session. Before executing this, let's select the appropriate database. We will select MDB for this session, like for our previous demo sessions for primary key and tables. You can use any user database as well to keep these tables for future reference or future testing or learning purpose. So this is our table 1, table EMP with two columns, ID and name. ID will be the primary key. I will insert some data in this table. Those are impacted. Similarly, we have second table EMP1. Similarly, two columns, ID and name. Again, we will insert the data in this table as well. So now we have two tables with primary key and some data. Now we will create the foreign key on one table. Table name is DEPT without cascade, and column names are DPID, DPT name, and employee ID. And in employee ID, we have mentioned foreign key reference EMP ID. That means this column is having the foreign key reference, and this is our table name EMP, and this is our column name. That means EMP ID column in department without cascade is referring to the ID column of employee table. So once we've done it, command completed successfully, and we will run the help against this table, and we will see in output. You can see we have a foreign key. This is a foreign key constraint name, and it's referring the EMP table and ID column. That means this reference works successfully, and SQL Server noted it, and it will be used when you will enter new records, and it will verify that all records or data inserted into this column must be available in EMP table, or you can insert null values, because otherwise you will get the foreign key violation message. Similarly, we have one more table, create table training, and then we have three columns, TID, training name, and employee ID. Here we have not mentioned anything like it, we want to have it a foreign key or not. So we will just create a simple table. Table is created because create table and create foreign key later using primary key, or create foreign key on existing table. So your table is already created. Now we are going to create a foreign key against it. Alter table, table name, your child table, add foreign key, column name on which you want to get a foreign key, reference to which you want to reference, the table name, the parent table name, and the referencing column ID. Once you run it, it will mark the reference. So let's run the help for this table and see. You can see foreign key constant name, and references EMP table and ID column. Now, we also mentioned in slide that foreign keys can also be created using unique keys or based on unique keys. If your table is not having primary key, having the unique key, you can also use that key column for the foreign key reference column. So we will create one table with unique constraint TAB1, and we will create TAB2 table with referencing reference key this. Commands and the mechanism or the understanding is exactly same when you choose unique key column instead of primary key column. We are just demonstrating this to show that you can successfully create foreign keys using unique keys as well. When you run the help against TAB2, foreign key constraint referencing column TAB:1. Now insert some values into child table. So our parent table is select star from EMP. Why we are running a select on EMP table first? Because we want to know what all data we have, so that when we insert testing data in department without cascade table, we should know what all can be inserted. We have copied the data of EMP or parent table here for the reference. Now we are going to insert data. Data completed successfully because this ID field 1, 10, 2, 4, and 11 is available in EMP. Now we are going to insert one data with the employee ID 44, which is not a part of employee table. So this is going to be an invalid insert. We will see what error we get. So insert a statement conflict with foreign key constraint. Foreign key dependent, this is the constraint name, and conflict occurred. This was I am explaining in the PPT as well and above session is and above as well, that in case you are trying to insert an invalid value which is not available in parent table, you will get the foreign key violation message. Now if you don't have any corresponding EMP ID, then you can use the null, and null is allowed. So you can see null value is successfully inserted. So let's run one select statement against this table and see what data we have in. So we have the null value because foreign key columns allow nulls or the values available in parent table column. Next is update cascade and delete cascade. As mentioned in slide, this is a useful feature when you want to get rid of unwanted data, delete it from primary key, or you want to update the primary key data in child tables as well. So we will create one table for this department with cascade. Now we will add foreign key, and we have mentioned on update cascade and delete cascade. You can choose either of them as well. Means if you want only delete cascade to be there, you can choose one of them, or you want only update cascade to be there, you can choose that. For demo purpose, I have mentioned the both for this table. So alter table, table name, add foreign key, column name, reference, parent table name, column name, on update cascade, on delete cascade. So your command is completed successfully. So let's run the help on this table. You can see in delete action it mentioned cascade, in update action it also mentioned the cascade, because we have mentioned this here. Now we will try to insert some data. Insert department cascade null. So your data is inserted. Before so now your data is inserted in department with cascade column. Now we will try to delete or update the data in parent table, and we will see the impact on child table for that. Before running the update and delete statement, let me have a select statement on these tables in separate window for comparing the results. So I'm going to run an update command where I am going to update the ID field, which is the primary key name, and I am using employee table here, EMP, for which child tables is not configured as a delete cascade or update cascade. So when you run this command, it said that update statement conflict with the foreign key, because this data is, because this value is referred by a child table without delete or update cascade, and this change is going to be create a conflict. So you can't do that. But when you do it on EMP1, for which child tables are created with update and release cascade, see what will happen. Command completed successfully. So let's go to the window where we already have the output. In delete car in EMP1, we have seen that ID of Rohit is 1. Okay, and this ID is assigned to department database. So we will run this out data here again and see the difference. Now you can see ID of Rohit is changed from 1 to 5, and same impact is here. ID against the department database changed to 5 automatically, because update is cascaded to all child tables automatically. Similarly for the delete, if you try to delete a data in primary key, similarly for the delete command, if you try to delete the primary key column or the primary key data in parent table or from parent table, it's going to create a foreign key violation when child tables are referring it without delete cascade. So let's run it, and again delete a statement create a conflict because reference keys are there. But when you do it for EMP1, it said command completed successfully. So we have deleted ID 2 in this output, which was prior to update and delete cascade testing. ID 2 was assigned to Peter, and Peter is also part of finance department. Now see the difference. When you run the select statement with the latest data, you can see ID 2 is not available in employee table or EMP 1 table. Peter is no more available here, and also the corresponding code with the department finance and employee ID 2 is also deleted. So deletes are cascaded to all child tables where that particular record is referenced. This is a useful feature and risky one as well. So before using this, I will suggest to have a proper testing and analysis whether you need it or not. View foreign key properties. Viewing foreign key properties, I am going to share two scripts for this. One is to check the available foreign keys or referred or child tables with the particular parent table and all constraints available in my database. So this is the first statement or first command, which will show the all reference child tables and column names for this particular EMP parent table. So when you run it, it shows that for EMP table, EMP ID column is referring this table by the table department without cascade and training. This is something very useful when you want to see what all tables are referring my table. And this command will give you a complete insight about the foreign key data. Department cascade is a table name. This is your constraint name. Source column is this. Target column, target table or target columns are this. Update rules cascade are there, because we have defined cascade for this table, and other tables are created without cascade action. So this particular command will give you a complete insight for all foreign keys available in your database, in particular database. And next is delete foreign key. To delete a foreign key similar to your primary key, we need a constraint name to delete it. For constraint name, with the above command, we can have the constraint name. And like this, we want to delete a foreign key for department with cascade column. And this is going to be our constraint name. Oh, I will change the constraint name here, and we will run the delete command. And now your foreign key was deleted from department with cascade. Let's run this again, and you can see that particular entry is not available. That means that particular table is not referenced by foreign key now. You can perform the similar type of operations from SSMS as well. You go in MDB, you have the tables EMP employee 1, TAB, TAB 2, and training keys. So you have a foreign key and primary key. You can just right click here and delete. It can delete the foreign key. foreign key. Now this table is not referring any other table. So this is how you can delete the foreign key. And to create a foreign key in existing table, just right click on keys. You will get an option of new foreign key. In new foreign key, in table and column specific, click here. In the primary table, you will get the list of the tables available in this database. Click on the table name, which you want to use as a parent table. Now you have the column list, select the column, click OK. You can also give the rules specification for delete and update. That update rule will be cascade or no cascade. So we are not going to change it, and just close it. Right click and save training table. Say yes. Close it. Once you refresh the columns here and the keys, you can see foreign key is created for this table. So this is how you can create a foreign key on existing table using SSMS. This is our small demo, how we can create foreign keys, how we can drop a foreign key, how we can create foreign key using unique keys, using T-SQL and SSMS. I suggest to have a small demo or practice session on your local system to get a hands-on SQL Server foreign keys.
We have covered our today's lesson over SQL Server foreign key. For any questions, please leave comments on video or contact us.